Hey guys, and welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Minecraft. Lola, I'm just recording on my phone, like, video, making a video. Making a video. I'm gonna put on YouTube stuff. Anyways, welcome back to. Yeah. This is probably the longest intro ever. Welcome back to another episode of Let's Play Minecraft, Minecraft Survival, the Pillage, and Village updates. So right now, I'm gonna go back to the cave. I'm gonna start mining some stone for my foundation. Okay, let's see if I can find a place for me to mine safely. excuse me for a moment. Sorry folks, my mom called on the landline. Just needed to make sure of something. Okay, so we're gonna get some more stone. Okay, so here's some random news. If any of you are from... So here's what I know. I'm watching the news right now, and I just heard of this, this shooting at Gilroy, California. My condolences to the victims, and, sorry. Man. I know. I don't know, I'm not an American, guys, but I do know some of America's rules. And I know for a fact that the American Constitution states that that everyone has the right to bear arms, but you know, seriously, but to bear arms against a person, to bear arms against your own countrymen, that's wrong. I don't know why people would want to do such things. You may never know what they do. Or why they do it. They may have been troubled. They may have been disturbed as a child. Anyways, let me check out my berry farm. Come on. I'm gonna get prickled to death, aren't I? Could use the bear. Could use the bone meal I just made. I need plenty of berries now. Yeah. Well, my heart goes out to the victim, to the families of the victims. Yeah. Anyways, in other news, protests in Hong Kong are entering its eighth week. Think. I know there are plenty of OFWs in Hong Kong at the moment, so to all fellow Filipinos, stay safe. It's gonna be a wild ride from here. Okay, I'm gonna need to get some more wood. Hold on a minute. Anyways, yeah, weird stuff has been happening. Let's go back to getting more wood. I'm watching CNN right now, so that's how I'm getting the news. Okay, we're laying down the floors for my house. Anyways. been making a lot of sticks today. A lot. More berries. I'm gonna die cultivating this. Now let's move some stuff inside the foundation before I set up the walls. I made iron tools. I forgot I put iron in there at all. Okay, now I'm gonna have to build the walls. I'm just gonna pause this for a bit. Man, are you listening to this? If any of you are watching CNN right now, if any of you are watching CNN like I am right now, you'd be laughing. Okay, we're gonna build. Okay, just gonna build the frame for now. I think I'm gonna get some granite from the cave and use it for the walls. Hold on. I need to craft an iron pickaxe first. Man, am I in talking? Do I talk less when I'm busy doing stuff like this? If let me know in the comments if I don't talk too much. during the games. For reserve. I'm going to be wasting all my iron for this. For pickaxe. Not X. Woo! Hold on, I got... Man. That stuff's crazy, isn't it? Okay, time to go down. So, granite. In real life, it's one of the hardest rocks on Earth. It's one of the hardest substances on the Earth. Hardest rock, anyway. In Minecraft, it's not. It's got about the average strength of stone when it comes to mining it. Okay, here we go.
Well, no, let me just ask you a couple of things, because you've raised a huge number of issues. So I first want to ask you about this. Look, the president basically said trade wars are good and they're easy to win. But this has been going on for, more than a year now, and it's not won. And, you heard what the farmers said. They would much rather have trade deals than aid. And some of them are officially complaining about how expensive things are becoming and how they're being hurt by retaliatory tariffs.
Okay. Okay, looks like my stone pickaxe is down. Let's go to my iron pickaxe now.
If not fair to other countries, to charge us much higher tariffs and engage in non-tariff barriers. So our philosophy in the administration, President Trump taking the lead on this, is fair, balanced, and reciprocal trade. And this is what defines the president's mission. And I think that it's important to look and see just how strong the economy is under his leadership and under this move, basically, to get this trading regime in a better place. I mean,
all right, here's the
6 million jobs. We've got 7 million people off food stamps.
More iron. Okay, so here's some more granite.
Low unemployment rates, blacks, Hispanics, women, the disabled, veterans. One of the things that
what just hit me? Must have been a creeper.
One of my favorite statistics is the fact that we created over 500,000 manufacturing jobs compared to a loss of 200,000 manufacturing jobs in the Obama-Biden administration.
Okay.
This is what we're focused on, and my point here is China is a small part of the bigger economic puzzle, and we shouldn't get fixated, and I'm not going to do that in this interview.
Right, but sir, you just talked about the American economy, and you say you're
going to take, you take this piece of iron.
This fight in China, and I'm trying to figure out whether you have an end game.
No,
the trade tariffs. The tariff. You started the tariff, and that is actually a tax which is hurting both Chinese and Americans. All the economists say that.
Okay. All right, let's get back to our island and start building the walls. First, I need to put some iron in here. Okay, here we go.
We hit 3% in 2018. We hit 3.1%.
Made a mistake there.
Are we worried about this latest number? I think the biggest problem that we had that's reflected in that data is the Federal Reserve, which foolishly began back in March of 2018 to raise interest rates. What would be a total of 100 basis points? And what higher interest rates do, Christian, is they depress investment and they depress our exports. And if you look at this 2.1% growth rate
that we
hit in Q2, it was above expectations. That's good news. But where did we lose it? We lost a full point because of lower private sector investment. And we also...
I'm going to take out the torches in here. Hold on. All right. Just had a little glitch with the TV. Well, it's back now. Okay, now we have some doors.
Let me just jump in a little bit because I just want to ask you about reports on, I mean, you're talking about exports and trying to make U.S. exports more attractive and trying to boost the economy, etc. So there are reports, as you know, because you were focused on them, over the weekend that you had recommended last Tuesday that the president weaken the U.S. dollar by about 10% in order to make U.S. exports more attractive to foreign buyers. One person in the room, according to Politico, said that you would, you know, barely begun your presentation and then, quote, before getting slaughtered by the president. Now, is that true? Did you recommend? Is the president against devaluing the dollar?
All right.
What happens in the Oval stays in the Oval, and I'm not going to be talking
now before about what happened in the Oval. Now, before I end this episode, I'm going to put this stone cutter down. I want to see how this works. So, as you all know, the stone cutter was added to Minecraft Pocket Edition when it first started, but then some updates later, it didn't exactly gain track. It became pretty useless. And now, it's got a new look, and it's back to its old use again, cutting stone. And it looks cool now, especially this animated-looking blade. Anyways, my 25-minute limit is about to end, so thank you guys for watching. Leave a comment, subscribe, and I'll see you next time.